What is up, YouTube? My name is Aditya and welcome back to my channel, The Indian Algo. And in this video, we'll be discussing about the points of interest that I use to take high probability intraday and swing trades. So before we move on to the charts, guys, you can go through the description and check out the links to our Telegram channel and my Discord group. So you can join the channels to be in continuous touch with me and understand what my trade ideas are for the future. For the coming days or for the next week, and we'll try to provide you high probability swing trades as well. And the other mentors who work with me are also going to give you some high probability intraday trades. So this is useful for people who trade forex and Indian markets as well. All right, so here we are. If you see, this is the daily time frame chart of Euro USD. So how do I look for and what do I try to understand is I go on to the monthly time frame first and I try to identify where is the price on monthly time frame. What is the possibility of the price taking out this low or to like push up higher? All right. So at this point, sorry. So at this point, it definitely looks like this low can be taken out because like we do not have any bullish candles or anything as such, but there's a big rejection, there's a very huge rejection, and there's a good body to the downside. So it's definitely a little confusing here, but let's see where we are at presently. So if we see, we had some fair value gap right here, so the price definitely took some support from that particular area and we saw some good reaction here. Alright, we saw some good reaction here. So definitely we are at a level where we can see some up moves on monthly candle as well. We can see some up move on monthly candle as well. So if I go to the weekly time frame here, what I would want to see is where the price could go on weekly time frame. So here, if you see, we have this bearish order block. So I am expecting the prices to reach out to this point currently. Now I'll move down to the daily time frame. And then from here, I'll try to anticipate what the prices could do. So if you see the weekly candle here, the weekly candle has not formed any sort of wick below here, below the opening price. So this is what my anticipation is. If you see, every candle here has a wick below and wick above. So if you guys remember my video on Wyckoff accumulation and distribution on daily time frame, this is it. This is very much the same concept here. So what I'm expecting the price to do is go below this low, go below this low. And as the price go below this low, I want it to take support from this precise level. And as the price test this precise level, if you see, this candle was acting pretty nicely here. Now, if you see, what I can see here is this smart money liquidity, where if you, where you might argue that we do not have equal lows here, but we do have one low and we have a body here. So above these two point levels, there is definitely liquidity right here. So if you see, if I will just mark this now, definitely I want the prices to fall down here initially, but this does not mean that I am expecting the prices to continuously move lower. So at this point, you can definitely be into a short trade, but that is low probability here. So my next view from here on, here onwards, is the price to come down to this area, take out all the liquidity here. Probably if it tests this order block, it's gonna be a very high probability trade once again. So you have these three points of interest where I would, yeah, so you can avoid this as of now, you don't really need this. So if the price like simply falls down, dips below, touches this area, starts taking support, this is where you can expect the prices to take out this particular high. Now this may not happen on Monday, this may happen on Tuesday or Wednesday. So Tuesday and Wednesday is going to be definitely going to be a very nice day if we are able to sustain above this level. If we are able to sustain above this high, definitely the markets are going to push up and the overall targets are going to be this. But if you want, you can simply lower it down to this point. Hence, this is going to be your intraday target and this is going to be your probably your second target. All right. So now what we can do is we can go on to the 4 hour time frame. All right. So everything looks nice here. Whatever we had discussed makes sense to me. I am anticipating the prices to push down for once, take support around this area, and then push up to take out this particular high. That would be a very high probability trade. Now, this is where a lot of people go wrong, because what they are trying to do is they're trying to identify break of structure and everything. Now they'll do this, but just because they have this swing high and this swing low, they are expecting the prices to push lower, but without realizing that there are higher time frame confluences that will not let the price push lower. If you see, we have these two equal lows as well here, so we may expect the prices to push down here. But what my trade idea is, what I'm trying to make you understand is, if you go through my previous videos, I always want to take trades where I can fight with the market and make money out of the market. Because what you guys are doing, you guys are taking a trade here, you guys are taking a trade here, trade here, trade here, trade here. What I'm doing is, I'm only going to take a trade in this particular zone where if I am getting an entry somewhere here, I'll take it and I'll expect the prices to reach out for this. But what you guys are trying to do here, just because you want to take a short, unnecessary short, you are trying to take a short here, price goes up, comes down. Like this was your SL hit. You take a short here, once again price goes up, hits your SL. Just because you want to keep smaller SLs, you are hitting your stop losses multiple times and decreasing your accuracy in this case. But if you see here, this is what we have. This is a very high probability trade. You can anticipate a candlestick that could look something like this on daily time frame. This is what I'm anticipating. So if I'm anticipating a move this way, I can expect lower time frame entries anywhere inside this range. So let's say this is around 100 pips. Let's just consider this is around 100 pips. So at this point, I just want to capture around 20 to 30 pips. Now let's say you are somebody who wants to keep smaller SLs. So what you are doing is, you have a range of 20 pips and you are trying to capture 20 pips. That will not work out. You can capture 10 pips maybe, you can capture 5 pips maybe, but you will not book your profits, I'm pretty sure. So once you have a bigger range, you know where you are supposed to fight with the market. If this does not play out, I will look for some other scenario, which I'll definitely share with you guys in the coming days. And also, yes, please make sure to join the Discord channel, join the Telegram group, and you will definitely see a lot of things coming up. And this is something that I've started for you all to understand my points of interest. And once you are able to anticipate these things, guys, you'll be at a very proper level of understanding the directional bias of the market. Once your directional bias is clear, everything will be sorted. I am somebody who trades based on candlesticks. And yes, high probability, sorry, higher time frame confluences. So this is something I want the prices to be here. And you can definitely, like, look, say you have this bearish order block, right? But I don't want to take trades inside this bearish order block. Just doesn't look good to me as of now, because this looks good to me and this area looks good to me. I want to be in from here and target this particular point till here. All right, guys, so this is where I'll end the video. Just in case you have any doubts, you can reach out to me on my Instagram profile. Instagram profile, and yes, I'll definitely try to clear all your doubts, guys. Also, don't forget to join the Telegram group. Make sure you comment down your views and anything that you want in future, so I'll definitely try to make a video on it. Thank you so much, guys. Have a nice day.